Okay, wait. I gotta unfold this.
Oh, he's first? He's
first. My bad.
Good evening, everybody. Welcome to Denver Jewish Day School Color War closing presentations, final presentations. It's good to have you all here tonight. Let's have a round of applause for all of our students who've been competing so wonderfully this week. During Color War, it's really a joy to see students collaborate in innovative and new ways. There are a few programs here at our school that we talk about often that make us unique and that are truly, truly experiences I think you can only have here at Denver Jewish Day School. Among them, of course, HIP, the Hebrew Immersion Program. Yes, we say there are trips to Israel, but nothing like HIP in 10th grade. New to Denver Jewish Day School in recent years, we've had intensives. That's a pretty special week following our winter break. And of course, the oldest and most traditional program that we have here at Denver JDS is Color War. And it really, truly is an amazing week. And I think one of my favorite things about it is, besides tonight, is hearing our graduates come back to school and tell us how things like Color War, but especially Color War, taught them life lessons that they apply in the real world, in their jobs, and how much it's helped them for their future. So that kind of stuff's really powerful and makes us all here really proud. So if you want to share this tonight with people who are not here, text them right now, because this program is streaming live. It's on the Denver Jewish Day School YouTube channel, and they can watch it. They don't have to watch it now, though. All of the videos will live there in perpetuity, and that includes some things that have happened earlier in the week as well. Some of the great programs that go along with it, such as Lip Sync, etc. And you can tour the decorated rooms. I got a personal tour this afternoon. They're pretty special, pretty unique. So you can see, again, all these things on our YouTube channel. Want to make sure I don't forget anything. I do want to say and recognize the fact that we had a tragedy in Denver at East High School this week, of course. And we actually gave some thought to whether or not it was even appropriate to come here tonight and hold this program. And we felt that although we are all impacted by that, we felt it's also important to gather together at this time, support each other, and bring this week to the special culmination that it deserves tonight in final presentations. So that is part of why we're here, to support each other as a community. Want to recognize just a few people and then turn it over to our students as they'll recognize some more people. Just want to recognize, once again, Jerry Rotenberg, who does so much to put this program together. Thank you, Jerry.
Yeah, Jerry!
And Jerry's team, Josh Lake, Melanie Knowles, and Chana, who has been mazel tov to Chana on her baby. Chana has been around for Color War Week and had a lot to do with the planning as well. So thank you to all of you. Thank you to our teachers who helped support our students this week. Thank you to our students. And it gives me great pleasure to turn things over to Aretz and Shamayim. Good luck, everyone.
Thank you all for coming tonight to final night of Color War 2023. Both teams have worked extremely hard to prepare for this moment, so good luck to both teams.
First, we would like to thank Mr. Snyder for everything he has done for our school, especially this week. We will miss you so much next year and can't wait to see what you do next.
Thank you to all faculty and staff for putting up with us this week, especially the administration for staying at school late while we work on our final presentations.
Yeah. Thank you, Ms. Ashley, for holding down the office and ensuring we have everything that we need.
Once again, a big thank you to Jerry Rotenberg, Josh Lake, and Melanie Knowles for making this week possible. You all are sensational.
Thank you to Trent for making sure all of the bells and whistles of DJDS are running smoothly.
Thank you to Todd and Brad for keeping us safe while we are going through this amazing experience.
Thank you to the kitchen crew for providing us with lunch and snacks at school during this week.
A special thank you to all of the lower divisions teachers, administrators, and students for being so spirited this week.
Thank you to Avital Robart for capturing all the wonderful moments from this week.
Thank you to our head of school, Avi Hazel, for allowing us to have this once-in-a-lifetime opportunity.
Thank you to the Adam Group for supporting the school and its efforts to educate the next generation.
Thank you to Coach Spencer Barclay for innovating new ways for the lower division to participate in Color War this year.
Thank you to all of the parents for your help and support this week, especially the Brunswicks, Noams, Friedmans, and Friedlanders for helping to provide snacks for everyone at the school.
We would love to introduce our fantastic alumni judges for the final night of Color War. Leah Schweid Griggs, graduating class of 2019, Alana Kaufman Bosco, graduating class of 2015, Donnie Charles, graduating class of 2005.
Gilly Hazel, graduating class of 2018. Shauna Mordew, graduating class of 2002. And Zach Silverman, graduating class of 2016. Let's give a big clap for our alumni judges.
Thank you to both teams for putting in so much hard work and effort this week. It is all about to pay off tonight.
Let's have an amazing night!
We got to do something real quick. All right, let's get rolling. We're gonna do something a little unusual tonight, the heck with the coin flip. Way we're gonna decide who goes first tonight, we got Jenga. Can we get the Jenga players up, please? You can make as much noise as you like. It's okay. The game that we had yesterday lasted over 30 minutes, but this one they promised me won't. Ready? Go.
All right, this is our quilt. We and many other students put in endless effort and countless hours to create the birthplace of the Jewish nation, Har Sinai. When we thought of an important aspect of Judaism that connects to Eretz, we thought of Chaim, life. Har Sinai is the origin of every Jewish person. Har Sinai is a very important mountain that leads up to God. When we were brainstorming ideas for our quilt, we realized that land is deeply connected to Shemayim.
Why? Heaven and earth teach us how to work together by giving us the Ten Commandments. We wanted our quilt to represent this.
For our quilt to represent this community, we made many different things. Here are a few.
At the very bottom of our quilt, we made a meadow with gorgeous little flowers. They represent the blooming and growth of Judaism.
The river represents the flow and passing of time. The rocks in the middle may stop the flow of things, but the river overcomes the challenges and works around them. This shows the strength that the land has.
Har Sinai represents where the Israelites transitioned from a group to a community, from a community to a nation. It is our duty to commemorate the land where this occurred. The Ten Commandments are such an important part of our history and heritage because it makes up the rules and understanding of how to be a Jewish people.
DJDS is a pluralistic school. The sunset shows different types of Judaism that we all come from. We can love who we want and be who we want to be. The colors are unique, but they can still blend together to be a community.
Todah rabah.
Hey, Ruby and Alyssa. You know, we've had a really great sophomore year so far. What has been your favorite part?
You mean besides Color War?
Well, obviously, Alyssa. Nothing can top all the fun we've had on Team Arid so far. For me, my favorite part of this year was definitely HIP, where we got to explore the land of Israel.
The Hebrew word Eretz means land, and it encompasses everything we see on our planet created by God. As Jews, we recognize our responsibility to care for the earth and give back to it, especially through the observance of several holidays such as Tu B'Shvat. These holidays provide unique opportunities to establish new connections with God and the physical world.
To begin, our roots. The terrarium showing the roots in the ground was always a key component of our banner. By being able to see the roots and keep the plants tethered to the ground, we see the origins of Judaism and our deep connection to the land of Israel. Our roots have been growing since Hashem told Abraham that the land of Israel will be his offspring's birthright.
The map of Israel is an ombre of different climates, vegetation, and ecological differences. Israel's commitment to ecological sustainability is deeply rooted in Jewish tradition and values. The concept of tikkun olam, or repairing the world, is a core tenet of Jewish ethics and serves as a guiding principle for environmental improvements in the world. Despite its relatively small size, Israel boasts a diverse landscape that includes forests, deserts, and a fertile agricultural region. Over the years, Israel has pioneered innovative technologies and practices that promote conservation and sustainable development, such as drip irrigation, solar energy, and waste reduction. The environmental diversity of Israel is embodied on this map with a blend of different species in Israel given to us by Hashem.
We also wanted to incorporate critical species mentioned in the Torah, such as the olive branches. When Noah's time on the ark came to an end, a dove brought him an olive branch, telling him that the land was finally beginning to be uncovered. These olive branches are represented here.
Next, the flowers represent how our Jewish roots cause us to bloom as a nation that has persevered through many tragedies, such as the enslavement of the Jewish people in Egypt, the destruction of both temples, and the Holocaust. Our flowers blossom to show that through all the tragedies we faced, we persevered and we will continue to thrive after all the challenges we face.
Wow, I had such a great time reliving our time in Eretz Yisrael.
Now it is our pleasure to introduce the one and only Team Eretz.
Hey, Meryl, we have to head to the farm at... Wait, what you doing?
Oh, sorry. What's up? I was just thinking how much I want to be an astronaut so I can spend all my time in the sky.
Let me bring you down to Earth for a sec. This isn't cloud cuckoo land. Let's just head over to the farmette. We're planting seeds for Earth Day.
I don't even care about Earth Day. Do you care about the Earth, Mr. Goat? Why would you? Ugh.
Yeah.
Yo, you good?
Who are you?
I was getting to that if you would just give me a second. Let us help you get the lay of the land. We're your guides, genies, angels, whatever.
The world is in danger, and you've been chosen to learn about this importance so we can help save it. As Jews, the land holds a special importance to us. Let me take you back to the beginning, to the Garden of Eden on Earth, to the land of milk and honey, to show you just how important our land really is.
Yeah, I'm gonna take my horse to the old town road. I'm gonna ride till I can't no more. I'm gonna take my horse to the old town road. I'm gonna ride till I can't no more.
I got the horses in the back, horse stock is attached. Head is matted black, got the bushes black to match. Riding on a horse, ha, you can whip your Porsche. I've been in the valley, you ain't been up off that porch. Now, can't nobody tell me nothing. You can't tell me nothing. Can't nobody tell me nothing. You can't tell me nothing.
Yeah. Yeah, I guess you're right. Maybe I haven't been in the right neck of the woods to be able to really appreciate the earth we have.
Yeah, did you know that in ancient Jerusalem, there were many laws regarding littering and taking care of the earth? Because as Jewish people, it is our job to take care of the land that Hashem gave us.
This earth is really the only one we've got. I can't believe Jews have so many laws regarding the earth.
Well, we live life on earth, on the land. We're alive and we're human. There's a sort of duality to it, like the land sustains us. Dust to dust, ashes to ashes, you know? We come from the land and then we return to the land.
Just like human life is short, so is Earth's. We have one chance on this land and we have to make the most of it. Tikkun Olam is the idea that we have as a responsibility to repair the world and will bring us closer to God. Taking care of the Earth is how we make the world a better place.
This brings so much more meaning to being alive. As humans, we've been made in the image of Hashem. Humanity is sacred and it is all special. Let us show you just how wholesome humanity can be.
Outside of this one church town, there's a gold dirt road to a whole lot of nothing. Got a deed to the land, but it ain't my ground. This is God's country. We pray for rain and thank Him when it's falling, cause it brings a grain and a little bit of money. We put it back in a plate, I guess that's why they call it God's country. I saw the light in a sunrise, sitting back in a 40 on the muddy riverside, getting baptized in holy water and shine with the dogs running.
See, wasn't that literally the most wholesome thing you've ever seen? Humans are so special. I love being alive, like nothing on Earth.
Well, it was definitely earth-shattering.
It was absolutely something. Like nothing else on Earth, perhaps.
Okay, so Earth and the land are important to the Jewish people. And humanity goes hand in hand with being alive. And in essence, being on Earth. What else? What makes the Earth go round?
Well, the Earth is just so cool. There's over 20 different terrains on Earth. Over Earth's 8 continents and 195 countries, there are over 7,000 spoken languages amongst many different cultures.
Wow, I think I'm starting to understand. Culture really does make this world go round. I mean, look at our people. Judaism is rich with traditions, and Jewish communities are so tight-knit.
Yeah, let's go see some real culture. We're taking you to the uber-diverse land of the Kardashians, traffic, kosher restaurants, Adam Sandler, and most important of all, the second ever Jewish school to win a basketball state championship!
Greetings, loved ones. Let's take a journey.
I know a place where the grass is really greener. Warm, wet, and wild. There must be something in the water. Sipping gin and juice. Laying underneath the palm trees.
Okay.
And
of the world, different culture. The land is like really important to defining who we are in the world we live in.
So what are you thinking? You understand the importance of the land. Eretz holds to all of us?
Yeah, and we're a part of it. I feel like I'm on top of the world.
Wow is right. That was pretty dope. It's just absolutely amazing how we can all make a difference in protecting our land, our home.
So, Mara, what are you thinking? You want to go plant seeds in the farmette?
Yeah, and then I can save the world. As cool as space in the sky is, the Earth is where we are, and it's what matters.
Wait, so you don't want to be an astronaut now?
I don't know, but I know whatever I do, I'll have all the time in the world. Well, actually, I do have one more question.
Oh, and what's that?
Who's gonna win this car war?
Shammai.
By completing this quilt, we are showing our Shemaim spirit. Our task was to make a quilt that represented our team using the guideline principles of Judaism and the Divrei Chaim. We did this using fabric, felt, lots and lots of paint, many cotton balls, and most importantly, our love for color war and our team.
In the Torah, Moses goes to the top of Mount Sinai to reach the Shemaim and talk to God. There, he receives the Ten Commandments, and Hashem gives the Israelites rules to follow in order to live good lives. Ultimately, Moses was chosen to be the messenger between the Shemaim and the people. Moses is then told all the rules he needs to pass on to the Israelites. He descends the mountain from the mountain, skin glowing as he was touched by God in the Shemaim.
Our quilt depicts Har Sinai rising through the clouds, touching heaven. On the top of the mountain, we put Moses radiating a bright light from the power of the Shemaim and God. On both sides of the mountain, we include the tablets of the Ten Commandments to represent our team and to show you the meaning and importance of Shemaim.
On one side, you can see the Hebrew letters Shin and Mem, together making the word Shem, which in English means name. If you add a hey to the beginning, you get God's name, Hashem, in English, the name, which we call him to mean holy. On the other side, you can see the Hebrew letters Yud as well as another Mem, which when put together make the word Yom, or in English, sea.
In the first Parsha, Bereshit, we learn about the creation of the world, and on the second day, we're told that God splits the water into two parts, the sea and the sky, otherwise known as heaven. Now, if you put Hashem and Yom together, you get Hashemayim, which in English is the heaven. You can interpret this as God's sea.
So, if God lives in the heavens and the heavens are just another half of the sea, it makes perfect sense why Shemaim means heaven, or as we all learned today, God's sea.
Together we brought God, the sea, and Shemaim to create one quilt that shows the power of heavens and our team.
For this year's banner, we decided to represent rising from the earth and ascending to the heaven.
On the base, there are the quotes, HaTovah HaTfilah L'Tzadikim Hi Hayei HaOlam Haba. The goodness which is in store for the righteous is the life of the world to come. And Kol Yisrael Yesh Lahem Chalek LeOlam Haba. All of the Jewish people, even sinners and those who are liable to be executed with a court-imposed death penalty, have a share in the world to come.
The first ladder you see is Jacob's ladder. When Jacob left Beersheba to be in Haran, he rested on a rock and dreamed about angels ascending and descending, a ladder going up to Shemaim.
The Zohar teaches us that the ladder is a metaphor for prayer. Prayer is how we climb our earthbound, from our earthbound existence to the heavenliness in the human soul.
The second ladder represents the Tower of Babel. After the flood, the people of the earth decided that they would build a tower up to heaven so that they could be equal to God. However, their steps were too large and they failed to reach the level of godliness that they aspired to reach. And this is why the second ladder has bigger steps.
At the very top of the ladder, we have a cloud to represent the Shemaim and God as we all aspire to climb our own ladder and reach the Shemaim.
In order to get to heaven, you have to take small steps and follow the Divrei Chaim. Tachlit, purpose. Kehila, community. Sakranut, curiosity. Yosher, integrity. And Hesed, kindness. This helps us reach for the clouds and eventually reach the Shemaim and be in Olam Haba. We learn from these ladders that we can only reach heaven through our prayers and the Divrei Chaim. Everything that the Jewish people are instructed to do, such as the mitzvot and the Divrei Chaim, are geared toward the goal of reaching the Shemaim. And now we invite the judges to come up and take a closer look at our banner. Here's Jacob's ladder with Jacob on the bottom, and here's the Shemayim cloud, and there is the Tower of Babel with bigger steps.
Someone spent the time.
Sit down.
Yeah, give me all your lunch money. That's what you get for being a nerd.
Why do you always bully me? You know you'll never get into heaven acting like this.
What are you even talking about? Heaven isn't real. From some made-up fairy tale.
Hey, why are you two fighting? Stop that right now.
Ha, I got him so good.
You know I watched the whole thing unravel, right?
What? Who is speaking to me right now?
It is none other than the Almighty Abishter.
Oh, wow. Cool, I guess.
Yeah, it is cool. But you know what isn't cool? The way you treated that boy and the way you doubted the existence of my heavens.
Okay, what do you want me to do about that now?
Well, it won't be easy, considering the rebellious and sinful lifestyle that you have lived thus far. But hopefully, your fellow brother can begin to show you the way.
Boys. Like that.
Wow, that was insane. I feel connected to a mishpacha for the first time in my life. But what else can I do to change and connect to the Shemaim?
That was the first step of many, but I'm glad that your mindset has at least changed. Now we need to put your thoughts into actions.
What do you need to teach me about Shemaim and how it connects to my Judaism?
The Shemaim is where your neshama goes before and after your life. Your neshama lives forever and becomes even stronger than it was on earth when it is in the heavens.
That is awesome. So what is the next step in my journey?
I think you need to look back upon the experiences that you missed out on in your past days. I want to show you what a young mensch would look like.
Are you a map? Because I just got lost in your eyes.
Oh my God, you're so corny. Oh my God, you're so corny.
Your next step in getting into heaven is to find a nice Jewish woman now that you have found your brotherhood.
You're right, God, thanks. Got an EpiPen because you took my breath away.
Flattering, but I'm already interested.
Soren, buddy, just ask her out, bro.
So, you're very pretty. Would you want to go get a bagel with me sometime?
Girls.
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 Heaven knows that I'm born too late for these ghosts that I chase with these dreams I inflate, painted skies in my brain. Every day I'm Carl Sagan in space to escape this old world, this old world. Some days I lie wide awake till the sun hits my face and I fade, elevate from the earth far away to a place where I'm free from the weight, this old world, this old world. Trust anything or anyone below the sun. I don't feel anything at all. I'm king of the clouds, of the clouds. I get lifted, king of the clouds, of the clouds. I get lifted.
That was such a great date. Call me.
I cannot believe she just gave me her number.
Yo, that's hype, bro. I told you it would work.
Thanks, God. I couldn't have done it without you.
Teamwork makes the dream work, my boy.
לבוא בין הגלים. אני אולי מרגישה כאילו זאת הפעם הראשונה.
Wow, that was incredible. Teamwork really does make the dream work.
It sure does, kid. I'm so glad you're becoming the mensch I knew you would be. Now, it's time to connect you with your newly found mishpacha with one final cheer.
And let's give a hand to these two teams. Wow. Hey, can we all give it up for these teams once again? That was amazing. That was amazing. All right. As always, the most important event is the last. Miss Melanie Knowles will explain the rules of cleanup.
I need a representative from each team for the ceremonial garbage bags. Teams will have up to 20 minutes to get this place looking like a school again. Go.
Okay, as was stated, they're going to be cleaning up for about 20 minutes. Can hang out in here and schmooze, and then the winners will be announced. After that, we have a party for the 6th through 12th graders. Pizza party, a little bit of dinner, and time to celebrate together. And everybody should be picked up, please, by 8:30. So the staff who have had a busy long week can all go home and rest, and students too. So we'll see you in about 20 minutes. Thank you. Some people would like to daven mincha while we're waiting. It's kind of the perfect amount of time. We gather in the back corner of the gym. That is the northeast side of the gym. A quick mincha service for anyone who's interested.
Yeah. every day. I will give of myself.
I will give of myself.
I will reach out my hand.
I will reach out my hand.
I will use this heart I've been given and take a stand. I have a voice. My voice is powerful. My voice can change the world. I have a voice. My voice is powerful. Stand up for what's right.
I'll stand up for what's right.
I will use this strength I've been given and be alive. I have a voice. My voice is powerful. My voice can change the world. I have a voice. My voice is powerful. My voice can change the world. Baruch Ata Adonai Eloheinu Melech HaOlam She'asanu She'asanu Betzalem Elohim Baruch Ata Adonai Eloheinu She'asanu Betzalem Elohim. I have a voice. My voice is powerful. My voice can change the world. I have a voice. My voice is powerful. My voice can change. My voice can change the world. I have a voice. My voice is powerful. My voice can change the world. I have a voice. My voice is powerful. My voice can change the world. I have a voice. My voice is powerful. My voice can change the world. I have a voice. My voice is powerful. My voice can change the world. I have a voice. My voice is powerful. My voice can change the world. Change the world.
It's all good, it's all good. God made it and it's all good.
It's all good,
it's all good. God made it and it's all good.
It's all good,
it's all good. God made it and it's all good.
It's all
good, it's all good. God made it and it's all good.
Thank you, God, for the gifts you bring, for the food we eat, for the songs we sing. We thank you, God, for the earth and sky, for our family's love as the days go by.
It's all good.
cheer, hallelujah, hava, hava na shira, cheer, hallelujah, cheer, hallelujah, hava, hava na shira, cheer, hallelujah, cheer, hallelujah.
This is the hope is still real, a Jewish home in Israel. And this is the time we stand as one, if not now, when we must be strong, our hearts turn to the east. Yeah, this is the hope that holds us together. See you.
still real, a Jewish home in Israel.
Candles on my vehicle, 890. Gonna shine invincible, no longer be the visible. Born through the struggle, keep on moving through all this hustle. Head up, head down, through all of the bustle. New York City, wanna flex your muscle. Look so down, look so puzzled. All around your fire, through all the rubble. Bound to stumble and fall, but my strength comes not from man at all. Bound to stumble and fall, but my strength comes not from man at all. Drive on till tomorrow, wipe away your fears and your sorrow. Sunrise in the sky, like an arrow. No need to worry, no need to cry. Light up your mind, no longer be blind. Him who searches will find. Leave your problems behind. It will shine like a fire in the sky. What's the reason we're alive? The reason we're alive.
Bound to stumble and fall, but my strength comes not from man at all. Bound to stumble and fall, but my strength comes not from man at all.
One more than what you know how to be. And this is a light of festivity when your broken heart yearns to be free. Do you believe in miracles? Am I hearing you? Am I seeing you? Eight lights, these rites keep me right. Bless me to the highest.
Song I wrote, you might want to sing it note for note. Don't worry, be happy. In every life we have some trouble, but when you worry you make it double. Don't worry, be happy. Don't worry, be happy now. Be happy. Don't worry, be happy. don't worry, be happy.
Look at me, I'm happy.
Give you my phone number. When you worry, call me. I make you happy.
Okay, we are ready. We have scores. Everybody, take your seats. Can we get the lights so we can enjoy the... You don't want to? All right. We have a lot of scores to go through tonight. So let's get started. The first competition to reveal today is earlier in the week and throughout the week was Sidewalk Chalk Art. The winner, Team Eretz! The next competition, the Bob Ross Art Competition. The winner, Eretz! The next competition, Giant Jenga, as we all saw, that was a tie. Mazel tov to both teams. Very interesting way to start. The next competition, the lip sync. Winner of 2023 lip sync, Team Shamayim. All right, the next competition, the dance. Winner of the 2023 dance, Team Shamayim. The next competition, the room. winner of the 2023 room, Team Shamayim. All right, the next competition, the quilt. Winner of the 2023 quilt competition, Team Eretz. The next competition was Banner. The winner of 2023 Banner, Team Eretz. The next competition, the final cheer. Winner of the 2023 final cheer competition, Team Shamayim. The next competition, the final competition, cleanup, was a draw. Ooh, figure that. Cleanup is never a draw. What could that mean? Okay. Taking all of that into account, with a difference of only a mere less than 110 points for the entire week, the winner of 2023 Color War is Team Eretz!